So friends, I am Professor G.N. Purohit from the College of Veterinary and Animal Sciences, Department of Veterinary Gynecology and Obstetrics, Rajasthan University of Veterinary and Animal Sciences, Bikaner, and I welcome you to my next lecture, and that is Canine Reproduction and Infertility. Now, for dog breeding, marketing and sales, there are certain legislations prevailing in different places and one should follow those legislations. Now, before we discuss something about the reproduction, let us understand the reproductive anatomy of the bitch. The anatomy of the bitch genitals is different from other domestic farm animals. The bitch genitals are located, here you can see, in the abdomen, and the ovaries are just underneath the fourth or fifth lumbar vertebra. The bitch has two uterine horns, both of which are generally located in the abdomen, and the ovaries are also located in the abdomen. The peculiarity of the bitch genital tract is that there is a steep curve from the cervix to the uterus, and from the vagina to the cervix there is a steep curve. Now this creates a difficulty in passage of the catheters inside the canine uterus, and all the more the external genitals of the bitch, there are differences in the location and shape of the external genitals over a wide variety of breeds, and sometimes one may be confused whether this animal is a female or not because of the more inclined location of the vulvar lips of the bitch. In the bitch, the ovaries are located 1 to 3 cm behind the caudal pole of the kidneys, opposite the third lumbar vertebra, between the last rib and crest of the ilium. The speciality of the canine ovaries are that they are concealed in a bursa with a 0.6 to 2 cm slit. Here you can see the ovary has been exposed from the bursa, and this is the ostium of the infundibulum. This is the interior of the ovarian bursa, and these are some of the corpora lutea formed on the canine ovary. So the canine ovaries are located within a bursa, ovarian bursa. Now we talk something about the canine estrus cycle. The dogs are monoestrus animals with interestrus intervals ranging from 4.5 to 13 months and an average of 7 months. The canine estrus cycle is followed, is evident first by a proestral bleeding, which averages 7 to 9 days. The bitch attracts male, but there is no mating. There is a vulvar edema. Then the estrus period in the bitch, which averages 9 days, there is a sexual receptivity. The bitch deviates her tail. Here you can see the bitch deviating her tail. The estrogen decreases at this stage, and rather the progesterone increases. This is peculiar to the bitch. The bitch ovulates a primary oocyte, and the first polar body may be released 48 to 60 hours post ovulation. So this is a sperm can enter a primary oocyte. This is very peculiar to the bitch. Then there is a period of metestrus or sexual quiescence. Some bitches experience pseudopregnancy. Pseudopregnancy is a mechanism whereby the CL persists, and on completion of the period equal to the gestation period, a bitch shows the signs as if she was pregnant. The pseudo-pregnancy in the witch is thought to be one because of the role of prolactins. The mechanism of CL regression is not known clearly in the witch, and role of prostaglandins in regression of the CL is unclear. Early CL, day 20 to 30, is resistant to the prostaglandins. Every witch experiences pseudo-pregnancy once or more times during her lifetime. This is physiological, there is nothing to worry. The puberty in the witch occurs 8 to 12 months. Large breeds are mated at 15 to 18 months. Pubertal bitches show split estrus and a vulvar swelling without male acceptance. The bitches with vaginitis and anal sac infection can attract male dogs. The bitch ovulates a primary oocyte, as I said earlier, which matures in 48 hours after ovulation, and the ovulation occurs 2 days after a LH surge. The transition from proestrus occurs 1 day after the LH surge, but can occur 3 days before to 5 days after the LH surge. The fertility usually declines very rapidly, beginning 7 days after the LH surge, as oocytes undergo degeneration and the cervix closes over a 1 to 2 day period. The fertile period for the bitch can be considered to extend from 3 days before the pre-ovulatory surge until 7 days after the pre-ovulatory LH surge, and maybe even longer when using stud dogs with exceptional semen quality or bitches in which the oocytes may survive another day or two beyond the normal. Importantly, for many dogs, the sperm may survive no longer than 1 or 2 days in the female tract. Matings earlier than the day of LH surge have resulted in reduced pregnancy rates, suggesting that in most cases, sperm are not capable of penetrating oocytes after 2 days in the female tract. Now, a common problem with bitches could be non-receptivity towards a male, and this could be because of a persistent hymen, vaginal hyperplasia, tumors, strictures in the vagina, and clitoral enlargement. Here in this picture you can see this is a vaginal bitch with vaginal hyperplasia, and this is a picture of a bitch having vaginal strands that are occluding the lumen. Now we talk of the breeding management of the bitch. The optimal time to breed can be determined by the LH surge or clinical methods. The average bitch may ovulate 12 days of proestrus and hence should be mated on day 14 and 16. However, a bitch may ovulate as early as day 5 of the proestrus to day 30 of proestrus. Hence, mating on a predetermined day may fail to result in conception. This seems to be very important. A poor correlation exists between behavioral events and endocrine events. Some bitches may refuse to accept a particular male. There are certain checks that usually the breeders around the world they perform, and these checks are very important to prevent certain heritable or the diseases that may be propagated by breeding that bitch. Usually, the bitches are bred in the second or third estrus. They should be looked for the health issues, and Labrador retrievers can inherit eye defects, and German shepherds are prone to hereditary hip dysplasia. Then progressive retinal atrophy, which causes blindness, retinal dysplasia, which causes eventual blindness, Coley eye anomaly, usually inherited, cataracts, and entropion are potential eye problems that must be looked for before breeding a bitch. Hip dysplasia is the deterioration of your dog's hip joint, so the hip socket sits too shallow in the head of the femur. This condition can lead to arthritic changes that destroy protective cartilage and can cause severe pain for your dog. This affects large breeds, usually affects the large breeds, but Cocker Spaniels and Shetland Sheep dogs might also be affected. So a bitch should be carefully examined by a radiograph, and the veterinarian should identify the potential problem. Because condition like hip dysplasia would not be clearly visible to the clinician before 2 years, bitches of larger breeds are suggested not to be bred before 2 years of age. The female breeding dog must be checked for osteochondrosis, desiccants, and elbow joint problem, and then the dog must be checked for patellar luxation if he is a smaller dog. Diagnosis for this condition is straightforward and surgery can correct this condition, but no dog with patellar luxation should be bred, and this is a hereditary condition. Then dogs should be tested for deafness. The hearing test, known as the brainstorm auditory evoked response Baird test, detects the electrical activity in the cochlea and auditory pathways in the brain. Dogs that fail a Baird test should not be bred. Many breeds will need to be checked for heart issues like subaortic stenosis and other malformations of the heart or valves. This puppy is undergoing the Baird test for a check of deafness. Then the female dog and the male dog, the sire, both should be tested for brucellosis before breeding. Now, approaches to time breeding in the bitch includes clinical methods, vulval softening. This occurs, you can see here, vulval softening. This occurs 1 to 2 days before ovulation and the turgidity disappears. Then a most reliable clinical method is vaginal cytology. A swab is taken from the vagina of a bitch, is rolled on a glass slide, fixed and stained with jimsa or maybe any cellular stain, dipstick or rites, and then the cells are examined under a microscope. A bitch in early proestrus will show plenty of red blood cells. As it transforms from early to mid proestrus, there is appearance of large parabasal cells. These are round cells with a large nucleus. As the bitch enters from proestrus to estrus, there is appearance of the epithelial cells, which are tetrahedral cells with a small nucleus, or they are anucleated. The vaginal cytology, the reliability is good, but not very high. Vaginal cells change from cuboidal to squamous epithelium. Then nearing ovulation or nearing the LH surge, 80% or more of the cells are cornified type or the epithelial type. So if a bitch is examined by cytology and if you find these type of cells, one must ask the owner to wait for 2 days more. Again, you perform a cytology, and if you still find these types of cells, you can again ask the owner to wait for another 2 days. When predominantly these types of cells are visible in a cytogram, then one can suggest the owner to breed her bitch. Then after the estrus is over, one can find these types of cells, maybe neutrophils, and then when the bitch is in estrus, one will find these types of cells in the vaginogram. Vaginal endoscopy can give you some information on time of breeding of the bitch. At proestrus, vaginal mucosal folds are adimatous and turgid, but they shrink at estrus. Ovarian ultrasound examination may be of value if you have the right type of probe and if you have the right exposure to perform an ultrasound examination of the ovaries. But it has been mentioned that ovarian ultrasound examination, you can examine the follicles in the ovaries, but it's mostly inconclusive as follicles do not collapse and echogenicity changes are inconsistent over the proestrus and estrus period. Then cervical mucus examination, you can find this is a slide of cervical mucus examination. Firm pattern is of value when combined with other methods such as cytology. A good approach is the evaluation of the plasma progesterone, which increases 2 days before ovulation. So if one finds an increase in the plasma progesterone, that is a good approach to suggest the owner to breed her bitch. Plasma luteinizing hormone assay can be performed, but daily recording is required, and that becomes cumbersome in a clinical setting. Then mating in the bitch, the dog and the bitch, they should be left in a familiar environment, and it's preferable that the female be brought to the male's place. The male would be unusual in the bitch's place, and so it's suggested to bring the bitch to the male's house. The male would sniff her vagina, sometimes it can bite, and then the male mounts on the female, and when it introduces his penis inside the female's vagina, there is a lock tie. The reasons this is a lock tie. The reasons for a lock tie are that the bulbogliandus located at the head of the dog's penis start to swell and enlarge as there is penetration of the penis in the vagina. And then the female vagina contracts, and the narrow passage makes it impossible for the male to withdraw his organ. This normally lasts for 15 to 20 minutes, but can last for as long as 30 minutes. One should not disturb the dogs while breeding, while mating. During the lock tie, the forced separation of male and the female may result into injuries both to the male as well as the female. Now we talk something about the canine infertility. With more and more purebreds being bred, with more and more interest of owners in breeding of bitches, more and more patients have been referred to clinicians for evaluation of the infertility in the bitch. However, the most common cause of infertility in the bitch appears to be the poor breeding management. One should be very careful for the management of the breeding of the bitch. The investigations should include the interestrus intervals, the length of proestrus, the breeding history. The causes of infertility in the bitch include, other causes of the infertility in the bitch include structural abnormalities of the reproductive tract. For example, the ovarian and uterine abnormalities are rare and usually diagnosed by exploratory laparotomy. Here you can see a uterus unicornis. One of the uterine horn is missing. And in this picture, you can see a stricture in the vagina, wherein there will be difficulty in the bitch conceiving, and many a times the male may refuse or the female may refuse for a mating. The problems of vulva include the structural abnormalities. Hyperplastic or recessed vulva in dogs is a common problem. The symptoms include excessive licking of the vulvar area, scooting, malodor, hematuria, and sometimes even urinary incontinence. There will be skin infections around the vulva, and it is suggested to treat the skin infection followed by a episioplasty. Congenital vestibulovulvar stenosis is another structural problem. Vaginal septa and circumferential vaginovestibular structures are the most commonly reported congenital vaginal anomalies of the dog. And as we have seen in a previous picture, the attachments can be broken, and then the bitch may conceive normally. A surgery may be performed. Then vulvar atresia, recessed or juvenile vulva, is frequently observed in female dogs of all ages. This may be a normal finding, unaccompanied by clinical problems. However, some dogs with recessed vulva develop persistent repeated infections of the vagina or bladder, and owners may confuse associated symptoms with urinary incontinence. It is often impossible to achieve long-term relief with antibiotic therapy alone, and surgical correction of the recessed conformation of the vulva facilitates treatment of the lower urinary tract infection. Then clitoral hypertrophy may be seen in a case of hermaphrodite, bitches with hyperadrenocorticism, bitches treated for prolonged periods with androgen therapy, and the treatment usually includes clitoral resection followed by neutering. Then abnormal discharge or abnormal placement in the vulva can be seen and can be treated with ease. The diseases of the vagina or the problems of the vagina include congenital defects. The persistent hymen is the most common one and is evident by pain during mating. Vaginal septa may be another reason for pain during mating, and they may be removed surgically via episiotomy. Vaginal anomaly must be suspected if there is urinary incontinence. Vaginograms using radiopaque material infused through a catheter can be performed to confirm the problem. The acquired abnormalities include vaginal hyperplasia. Vaginal hyperplasia is the swelling of the vaginal walls, leading to exposure of the vaginal mucous membrane outside the vulva lips. This is due to high estrogens and common in the first estrus and common in the Saint Bernard, Bulldog and Boxer breeds of dogs. The recurrence is common. Usually it recedes following the completion of the estrus period. The treatment include oral administration of mesosterol acetate 1 mg per pound for 7 days in proestrus, or the administration of GNRH 50 microgram once intramuscular. Then the vaginal prolapse, one must be very clear about the vaginal prolapse, which is seen in this picture, and vaginal hyperplasia, which is seen in this picture. The entire circumference of the vagina protrudes out, and here you can see this is the vaginal case of vaginal hyperplasia and this is a case of vaginal prolapse. The cause of vaginal prolapse is constipation, dystocia, forced separation during a lock time, and therapy includes repositioning under general anesthesia and episioplasty. The most common clinical complaint of the female dog is pyometra. Pyometra, or the cystic endometrial hyperplasia pyometra complex, is one of the hormone-mediated diastereal disorder of bitches about 8 to 10 years of age. It may be open or closed. Open when the pus is discharged outside, and closed when no pus is discharged outside. Pyometra is the bacterial interaction of an endometrium under prolonged progesterone exposure, resulting into accumulation of uterine glandular secretion. A bitch with pyometra is seriously ill. It will show signs of polyuria, vomition, fever, pus discharge, depression, and it usually occurs subsequent to a mating, 4 to 10 weeks of an estrus. A bitch with signs of gastritis, not responding to routine therapy, must be suspected for pyometra if she is about 8 years of age. The diagnosis can be done by radiography. Here you can see in this radiograph there are lumps of the uterus which can be visualized in this radiograph. And then ultrasonography, you can see here plenty of fluid in this. Then sacculations are visible in an ultrasound, wherein you can find sacs of pus in the uterus. And this one is a uterus of a bitch with pyometra that was removed surgically. The treatment usually The medical treatment would include the administration of antibiotics and the administration of prostaglandins, but the most appropriate therapy would be ovarian hysterectomy, removing the uterus and the ovaries of the bitch. As we talked earlier, pseudo-pregnancy is another physiological event occurring once or more times in the life of a bitch. The bitch shows false signs of whelping, nesting behavior, mammary enlargement, and voiding of milk. The exact etiology is unknown, possibly high prolactin levels and a failure of proper islet surge. The therapy includes administration of 40 microgram meblerone orally for 5 days or 1 milligram per kg of testosterone intramuscularly once or 2 to 5 milligram per kg of bromocriptin orally. Then metritis is common post-whelping, and a bitch is seriously ill, and it would require holistic therapy including the administration of plasma volume expanders, antibiotics, prostaglandins and other medicaments to manage the problem. Then tumors in the bitch, ovarian and uterine tumors are uncommon. Benign tumors of vagina and vestibule are the most common ones. The most common tumor in the dog appears to be TVT, transmissible venereal tumor, also known as lymphosarcoma, histiocytoma. This is a coitally transmitted neoplasm affecting both sects of dogs and considered to be more prevalent in dogs with free sexual behavior or free sexual matings. The transmission is through cell allograft transmission. It is one of the tumor in which nodular to cauliflower-like growths 5 mm to 10 cm appear on the vagina of a bitch. Here you can see. And on the glans penis of the dog. There will be hemorrhagic discharge, which is the most common finding in the bitch. The diagnosis is through symptoms, biopsy and impression smears. Impression smears taken from this place would reveal under the microscope a slide like this. Round cells with pycnotic nuclei and mitotic figures. The therapy includes administration of vincristine 0.025 mg per kg intravenous once weekly for 2 to 5 weeks or other anti-cancer drugs like methotrexate 0.3 mg per kg orally daily for 10 to 15 days, cyclophosphamide 1 mg per kg orally daily for 10 to 15 days, or radiation therapy or surgical removal of the growth followed by administration of vincristine. The prognosis is good. Tumor is self-limiting. This is one of the tumors which is having worldwide attention because there is a growth phase, then a static phase, followed by a regression phase. No other known tumor is having a regression phase. So this is a tumor which is of interest for the oncologists. Then dystrophia adiposa genitalis or Froelich syndrome is a disease of both sexes of dogs due to tumors of pituitary. The symptoms include obesity of the neck, genital atrophy, ulcers of extremities, diabetes insipidus, and the therapy is surgical removal of the pituitary and administration of thyroid extracts. Then one condition which affects the spayed bitches is hypoestrogenism. It is a disorder of spayed bitches. There is alopecia of perineum, abdomen, thighs, and often occur in bitches spayed before their first estrus. The bitches may also experience urinary incontinence. The treatment include oral administration of diethylstilbestrol daily for 2 to 3 weeks. Infectious infertility in the bitch. Brucella canis is the most common cause of abortion in bitches. occurs 30 to 57 days of gestation. There is prolonged discharge for 1 to 6 weeks after abortion. Then Toxoplasma gondii, it causes abortion, premature birth and neonatal deaths. Another common cause of abortions in the canals is canine herpes virus. Canine herpes virus causes infertility, abortion, fetal mummification, premature births, and venereal transmission is possible. There is development of vesicles on the vestibule. The functional abnormalities of the canines include delayed puberty and prolonged anestrus, which is not showing estrus even after 2 years of age. Unobserved estrus is common in fastidious bitches. Prolonged estrus intervals of 26 to 36 weeks. Now, it's difficult to define a prolonged anestrus. Basenji breed shows first estrus at 300 days and then annually. Bitches with anestrus must be investigated for the thyroid disorders because it's usual for them, for bitches having thyroid problems, to evidence anestrus. So first they must be investigated and then they may be treated accordingly. Estrus can be induced in bitches by the administration of diethylstilbestrol or FSH and LH, combinations of FSH and LH, GnRH agonist, leuprolide acetate, 100 microgram per kg, or long-acting desloralin implant have been found to be successfully induce estrus in the anestrus bitch. But the most common and most appropriate therapy would be administration of antiprolactins. Bromocriptin, administered at the dose rate of 20 to 100 microgram per kg daily for 7 to 12 days, would induce a fertile estrus in an anestrus bitch in which there are no other problems. Then 25% of the greyhound bitches show silent estrus. Then there could be a split estrus, vulval discharge for a few days without estrus. Then prolonged proestrus or estrus in bitches with longer than 30 days proestrus, estrus or ovulation must be induced with administration of HCG, 20 international units per kg, IM or IV. Ovarian cysts are uncommon in the bitch, mostly detected in older bitches at ovarian hysterectomy. They are frequently of parabursal origin and less important as clinical entirety. Estrogen-producing cysts may sometimes produce persistent estrus with vulvar discharge, flank alopecia, and hyperkeratosis. They can successfully be treated by administration of HCG. Then hypolutidism is a problem which affects the bitches where there is a lack of progesterone support resulting in abortion. Progesterone 2 to 5 mg per kg can be administered orally daily from day 20 of gestation. So thank you very much and kindly share the video and subscribe to my YouTube channel Govind Narayan Purohit if you like them. Thank you very much.